On this episode of Eat Sleep Drive, we are installing purpose-built winter tires from Cooper Tire. But first, before we do that, we need to get our money's worth out of these stock tires. Welcome everyone to another episode of Eat Sleep Drive. It's a little bit of a chilly morning here, and with chill in the air, it means it's time for snow tires on my FRS. I'm a big fan of putting purpose-built tires on your car given the season. So put summer tires on in the summer and then winter tires on in the winter. What we have here are these Cooper Discover True Norths. These are their dedicated winter tire, and they sent them to us to put to the test. But the first thing that we have to do is go get these things mounted. So we're gonna head to the tire shop, install these Cooper Discover True Norths, and see how they do. As you can see, my stock tires were pretty thrashed. So these tires were a much needed upgrade as we entered the Ohio winter. Over the course of the winter, I put these things through dry but cold conditions. Heavy rain conditions, and of course, snowy conditions. Here are my thoughts summarizing one winter season with these Cooper tires. So the footage that you saw was about 3 months ago, roughly 3,000 miles of the Ohio winter I have put on these tires. And what are my ending thoughts as the season sort of is starting to come to a close with the winter tires, these Cooper Discover True Norths? Honestly, I'm super impressed with these things, and it's not just the snow ability of these that is great. I've only really driven in these in light snow just because it hasn't snowed very much in Ohio. But the beauty part of winter tires is more than just about snow, because they are in fact winter tires, not just snow tires. Previously, winter tires were more just snow tires, but really the compounds are what have come such a long way. The compound is what makes winter tires winter tires. Basically, when it gets cold outside, all seasons and even more so summer tires, they get super hard. And when tires are super hard, they basically just have no grip. What is great about winter tires is the fact that the compound is made for the cold. So it's about roughly 45 degrees outside today, and I was just out there kind of playing, pushing my nail into the tread of the tire, and it's so soft still, despite it being, it's not ultra cold, but despite it being cold outside, but it's like that even when it's, you know, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, and that's what gives you more grip, even in the dry, when it's winter time, and not just snowing, and not just icy out, which these tires are very good at. But that's a benefit you get with winter tires, is that the compound is made for it specifically. Now, let's also look at the siping on these tires. Siping is something that they put in all seasons, but they also put them in winter tires like to more of an extent. If you look at that diagonal pattern that you see in the tires, check that out on these tires. I mean, huge siping, that's great for snow, ice, even wet driving conditions. I've had, you know, I mean, these things grip really well regardless of the road condition. And to be honest, I slide this car everywhere. I really enjoy myself even with these winter tires, and they're not chunking in the rear. I don't see any sign of perceivable wear. You know, it's only 3,000 miles, but I don't see any sign of perceivable wear with these things. And it's been a relatively warm winter. That's something that sometimes you're worried about. If it's warm outside, you're gonna wear the tires more because they're made for the cold. But these have been totally fine. What are the downsides to these things? I really haven't noticed any downside as far as noise. They are about as noisy or at the same noise level of the stock Primacy tires. So that's something to keep in mind. I really don't think they're any louder than the stock tires, so that's good. But as far as downsides, the only thing that I can see, and it's probably not something that's just specific to the True Norths, but it's something I've experienced in other competitor winter tires, and it's just the nature of the beast with all that siping. the turn in is slightly delayed. You get this little delay in turning, and it feels like the tires like just catch up. They're like, oh, a little bit delayed, catch up. And that's like when you put a side load of lateral grip on a tire with like a lot of siping, like these tires have, you're just gonna get that delay. So it's not the sharpest steering response tire, of course, being that, you know, it is a winter tire. So that is something that you will sacrifice with these tires. But in the grand scheme of things, they just grip better. You know, I would much rather have a rear-wheel drive car like this with winter tires in the winter than an all-wheel drive car with all seasons, because you're getting the added benefit of the additional stopping ability, which is like significant, or which is specific to tires, right? All-wheel drive cars can accelerate better in snowy driving conditions and stuff, assuming equal tires, but they can't stop any better. It all comes down to tires when it comes to stopping distance. So despite the fact that you might have an all-wheel drive car, if I'm sitting here with rear-wheel drive on winter tires, if you're on all seasons, I'm gonna be able to stop faster than you in adverse, you know, cold, snowy driving conditions. So it's the same thing with the handling and stuff like that. All-wheel drive, the only thing it does is really help you with acceleration. So it's something to keep in mind. People think that they have to have all-wheel drive for the winter. I would much rather just buy the car that you want to buy, regardless if it's all-wheel drive, front-wheel drive, rear-wheel drive, and just put purpose-built tires like these tires on, and you'll just be so much better off. You just get the benefits of that compound, and you know, it's just, you buy the purpose-built for whatever you want to do, right? So it is a little bit more of a cost, obviously, but the big thing you need to keep in mind is that you're extending the life of your summer or all-season tires as well. You know, when you put your winter tires on, you are, you know, not burning those up. So, you know, it's not exactly like this insane cost like everyone thinks. There is a bit of more upfront cost, but you're sort of getting a longer life out of each set of tires. So, you know, once again, when it comes back, bringing it all back to the Discover True North, I've driven a lot of competitors' tires, which are also very good, but these are priced quite low. They're, you know, basically some of the cheaper winter tires that I looked at on Tire Rack for the FRS, and they certainly don't perform like the cheapest tire. They perform great. Ride quality is great. I haven't noticed any difference there. They're maybe slightly softer than stock, so the ride quality, if anything, was probably a little bit better, but it's not compromised in any way. There's no additional noise. You get better handling and traction in the cold, regardless if it's snowy or not. And you know, the only downsides are the little bit of muted or delayed turn-in, but happy to pay that price for all those other benefits. These are great tires, and I would honestly recommend them to anyone. If you're in the market for winter tires, check them out. If it makes sense price-wise and stuff like that, I think they're a really good buy, and I wouldn't mind putting these on my cars in the future. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you found it helpful, not only just information about these Discover True Norths, but also just information about winter tires in general and why they have the added benefits that they do. If you want to follow me in between episodes, check me out on Instagram at EatSleepDriveTV. If you have any questions or comments about these tires or anything really, leave them down below. Appreciate you guys watching. If you stuck it out this long, hit the like button and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. I would appreciate it. Otherwise, I'll see you guys on the next one.